Dr. Mindy here, and on this video, I'm going to answer the million-dollar question. How long do you need to fast to stimulate autophagy? Now, if you've seen my other videos on autophagy, I'm going deeper into the timing of fasting on this video, so stay with me here. I want you to get the nuances because it's important for cellular healing. Let's go into timing. This gets asked so much. So I want to give you three major points here. I want to talk about the hours, and I want to talk about when autophagy peaks. I want to talk about the different organs in our body that are easily stimulated by autophagy and why you might want to go to some of these longer hours. And then I want to answer the question of autophagy versus mTOR. How often do we want to be in autophagy? When do we want to look at mTOR? And if you don't know about mTOR, I'll explain that as well. Okay, first point. I've already mentioned this, at 17 hours autophagy starts, and the research shows that it will continue till 72 hours of fasting. That's what the research we have right now is showing, that it's somewhere between 17 to 72 hours you are getting this autophagy effect from fasting. Now, there are many people believe that it really fully kicks in at 24 hours. So if you are really experienced with fasting, you know you're fat adapted, then you may do really well this week and all weeks with more 24-hour fasts. There is belief that it will peak at 48 hours. The research on this 48-hour peak of autophagy, I can't find the research, but I find a lot of experts out there talking about it. And what I do know from watching so many of you go through the fasting experience, the longer you fast, the more your body heals. So it would make sense to me that 48 hours would be an incredible peak for autophagy. Now, what happens at 72 hours? I want you to think about this for a moment. So in this fasted state, 17 hours, it starts to kick in. The body's like, okay, I'm gonna repair myself. At 24 hours, you get intestinal stem cells. We've talked about that in here. So the stem cells are repairing, and autophagy is ramping up in the other cells. So 48 hours, again, we're hitting this high point for autophagy. Your body's in this massive self-repair phase. And then somewhere on that third day of water fasting, your body's going to switch over and it's going to start to make stem cells. And stem cells are cells that can go and heal as well. So between 48 hours and 72 hours, we've got this maximum healing effect. You've got autophagy at its peak, and you've got the body starting to ramp up in systemic stem cells. So those of you that really are looking for that deeper healing, I love this idea of somewhere between 48 and 72 hours being that magic moment for repair. So that's how I feel about the timing. Second, the concept I want to talk about with the timing is, remember that every single cell in your body is programmed for healing, and they all have this autophagy effect, but the autophagy will be stimulated at different rates. My two favorite cells in the body, well, I'm going to say three, that I really focus on when I do autophagy fasting are the neurons in my brain and on the outside of my ovaries. As a menopausal woman, I really want to make sure that every little bit of sex hormone production that I'm getting, the best version of that. And the cells on the outside of your ovaries are programmed, they are primed for autophagy. So the more autophagy fasting you do, the more you are repairing those cells. Men, same thing on your testes. The cells in the testes have a tremendous amount of hardware in there to be able to trigger autophagy. And I don't know if you're familiar with the news right now, but there's a lot of mainstream news coming out saying that our testosterone is low in both men and women, and it's because of toxicity. Well, gosh, if we do more autophagy fasting, we start to stimulate these cells on the outside of the ovaries and the testes, and we can improve testosterone production. So I'm a fan of using it for hormonal repair, both men and women, especially testosterone. The other thing I want you to realize is your brain is the most important organ. I like autophagy for stimulating neurons, especially those of you losing your memory, anybody who's got Alzheimer's or dementia. And the last place that I like to think about autophagy fasting for is the liver. Hardest working organ in your body, and the liver really needs you to be cleaning it up and repairing it, because we live in this toxic world and the liver is trying to make you ketones, the liver is making cholesterol, so the liver is helping you regulate your blood sugar. So those of you that are struggling to get into ketosis, more autophagy fasting so that we can repair, we can stimulate autophagy in the liver, the ovaries, and the brain. So just, I want to bring to your attention that each organ has different capabilities of autophagy, and we can use autophagy fasting to heal these organs, okay? Third thing, what do? Autophagy versus mTOR. Just like night and day, they can't both occur at the same time. Autophagy and mTOR can't happen at the same time. Autophagy is self-repair. mTOR is growth. So when we want to build muscle, we focus on mTOR. You get more mTOR stimulation inside the cells by eating more protein and not fasting. Autophagy, self-repair. So we want to make sure that you're cleaning those cells up, you're burning fat. So I like autophagy for if you want to get lean muscle, you want to bring your weight down, do more autophagy. You want to build muscle, you're training for an endurance race or a big competition, those of you that are athletes, then you're going to want to do more mTOR. I think you should spend about 80% of your time in an autophagy, regardless of what you're trying to do, and 20% in mTOR. So there is a balance between going in and out of these two things. And women, those of you joining me for the May Reset, I will be teaching you these concepts and timing them around your hormones. So join us for that. Just put May Reset in the comments and I'll make sure you get a link to it. But that's the fasting timing of autophagy. It's nuanced. It's not as easy as me just saying, do 17 hours. Think about what your body needs. Think about how much you want to be in autophagy, how much you want to be in mTOR, and then plan your fast around that. As always, I hope that helps.